Hey, all reckoners, and welcome back. Today, I thought we'd take a look at Tree of Savior. This is a MMO that I've been playing for a while, and I took a break for Dark Souls 3, and I'm back to kind of playing it again. I don't think this is going to be a series. I kind of just wanted to show off the game a little bit, because I think it's a really good game. It's going to hit free-to-play relatively soon. So I guess where to start? There is controller support. I'm playing with mouse and keyboard. Currently, I'm a monk, so the way the game works, this is the most important thing about the game, the thing that hooked me in, is not character information, classes and skills. So, I started out as a cleric. Now, each time you level up 15 ranks in your class experience, two new options will become available to you. So, when I hit level 15, in my cleric, I had the option to become a level 2 cleric, a level 1 priest, or a level 1 whatever the other option was. I don't remember exactly what it was called. And so I went priest, and I went priest two more times, and then I've gone one into monk. So that means I'm level, what, 45, 60, 75? Roughly level... Does it tell me overall? It doesn't tell me overall. But, so I'm level 75. Each time you level up, you get to put one rank into one of your skills, and each time you go to a different rank, it unlocks more skills. In addition to that, you have your character level. So I'm currently in character level 127, and all that does is each time you level up, you can put a point in one of these skills, which does things. Your strength increases damage, constitution increases your HP, etc., etc. Gear, you only have... You kind of have these slots. There's torso, legs, boots, gloves, both your hand weapons. You got a couple of bracelet slots. Your costume, which determines how you look. Your gear, other than your weapon slots, doesn't affect how you look at all. It's all about this costume slot, which is why I look like a monk currently. Headgear, again, does nothing on its own that I've seen, but you can enchant it to give you buffs. But enchanting is very random, so it's very inconsistent. You're encouraged to wear armor of the same type, because all of the level 1 classes have the rank 1 in cloth mastery, leather mastery, and plate mastery, and they all do different things. Like cloth mastery increases your effectiveness of your magic, leather mastery increases your dexterity, and plate mastery increases your toughness. And the reason I have it equipped, because I'm like a cleric monk, so I'm this really weird hybrid between like a melee DPS class and a healing class. The reason I have plate is because it increases my stamina. And stamina is this diamond up here to the left of my HP and mana. As I run, that will go down. And there are certain things you can do to restore mana. It's very important for me because as a monk, I have this move called Double Punch, which is very high damage, and essentially no cooldown, and it's free, in that it doesn't cost mana, but it costs stamina. So it's very important that I have the ability to use this double punch and still move afterwards. Now, the cool thing you're seeing here, all these people, these are players. These are all merchant players who do things. There are no professions in this game. Like, as a monk, one of the things I could have done instead of going into a monk, I'm not sure if the level's quite right on this, but one of the things that you can, classes you can get into as a base cleric is, are there any right now? Basically, you get the ability to sell your buff spells as scrolls, and you can be that merchant. But, if I'd done that, I would have, lost levels in my priest or monk type thing, because there's a finite level cap. So you have to choose based on what you want to do, and I really, really like that. Your character is kind of bound to this role, which is interesting, at least. It can be frustrating. You can get tired, I suppose, but I think it's really cool. So I guess I'll show you what the combat actually looks like. You'll notice that giant action bar on the bottom, those are all tied to keys. So Z is attack, X is jump. Those are the only two that aren't on there. All the rest, you can see the numbers on them. Part of the reason behind my build as going into a priest is I get a lot of buffs. So buffing myself as a monk is really cool. I actually want to go that way. So this is a teleport. You can worship these things to teleport around. Where am I trying to go to? Sierra Rainforge is a way out. Mercenary Post, no. The Man of Sunbird. I think I'm gonna go Starving Demon's Way. Show me the map. Starving Demon's Way, that's where I want to go. Why can't I teleport to the Salus Covenant? Did I not actually unlock the teleport there? That's annoying. But it means I get to run through a low-level area, which means I get to look like a very strong champion. Even though my champion is, I suppose, averagely strong. Leveling this guy was painful. Because going level 1 cleric into level 3 priest, you're pure support. Like, I couldn't put talents into make my healing good, because I'm saving it to make my monk part good. So my healing was mediocre at best, and I had really powerful buffs, but solo, so it was great for groups, but my solo playing, I would never die, but it just took forever to sit there holding Z while you slowly whittled your target down. It's the worst. Things are much better now that I'm a monk. But those were dark times in the past. What is that? I got too close to the teleport. It pulled me through. I wanted to talk to the statue. I'm very curious what that was. I have no idea. One downside, one cool thing that's also kind of a downside in this game, is it's very reagent heavy. So a lot of my buffs consume things. Wait, have I not been out this way? What the cuss? How did I get to... I mean, I've been out here. How did I get out here? Is there a shortcut through Muller's Passage? That's bananas. But that does mean I get to go through Starving Demon's Way and there will be missions for me to do. So the interesting thing about this game is most of your experience is not obtained from completing missions or monsters directly. Like, doing those actions will get you very minimal amount of experience. Doing dungeons will get you a good amount of experience, but everything else, kind of none. Where you get most of your experience, I find, is when you complete missions, the main form in which they reward you is these experience cards, which you can consume to give you experience. Now, you don't just use them right when you get them. Basically, you play the game until you can't. All the zones that are supposed to be at your level, these level recommendations on them, if you've done all the zones and the only zones available to you are like 5 levels higher than you, that's when you start consuming those cards to make yourself the right level. Because physically grinding up to the next level is going to take forever and it's going to be painful. So you do that. And also, leveling in this game is very non-linear. At certain points throughout the game, the amount of experience required to go from one level to another is kind of reset. Like at level... What is it? When's the first one? I think there's one at level 84. I don't remember this one before that. But like, so... I may have the numbers wrong here, but just as a ballpark figure, let's say level 83 to 84 takes 10,000 experience. Level 84 to 85 will take 1,000. Now, these are roughly, I think, supposed to line up with when you get to a new rank, so that way you can get new points in your new spells a little bit faster, but it's not a hard science. Excuse me, what is this? The Guild Tower, Pandora's Box. I'm not in a guild, I don't know what that is, actually. That looks like a player-created thing. Being a guild master is actually one of those job type things. So for somebody to create a guild, they have to make a character who is a Templar, which basically means like their main purpose is to be a guild master. I mean, they have their class levels before that. All right. NPCs don't clearly tell you whether or not they have quests. Like, she's just sitting here. I'm gonna hit space to talk to her. Hopefully she has a quest. Hey, I'm so hungry I can't move at all. Anything will do. Please give me something to eat. Ask her what kind of food she wants. The meat of those monsters over there will do, please hurry! She's actually like a flesh eating monster, isn't she? But it does tell you which things are for a quest. So this thing right here, if I destroy it, would completely restore my stamina. But I'm kind of like essentially full stamina. It goes to full, so there's no reason to destroy it now. How many have to kill? Oh, I need to kill as many as I possibly can. Or just keep killing them until they give me meat, as it were. That's pretty cool. Sampo! I killed that guy for no reason. Oh, the grabbers are bugging out down there. There is a thing in this game where you get experience for just kind of killing a variety of monsters, like having killed enough of each monster and, you know, fully exploring the map. So it rewards exploration that way. But it's a little tedious. The gameplay itself is a little tedious. So I have very mixed feelings about that. Like, you know, maybe it's just my class. I should probably just try other classes, because for the most part, with this guy, I just kind of put on buffs and hold down Z until they're dead. Because you can't move very quickly. There is definitely, position is definitely a thing, like on bosses, to avoid like their AoEs and whatnot, but this doesn't alleviate things greatly. Do I have any meat yet? Okay, I have one meat so far. These things look like pumpkins. I'm surprised they even have meat. Well, they don't have meat apparently. They barely have any meat at all. I'm gonna hit you with this new move I got. Bam! It's a cool move, and it applies a dot, but it knocks them back, so I don't know how much I like it. God dang it. So, one thing I should probably show you, because it's actually really cool, is my heal, my main heal, my starting move heal, is this. It puts a bunch of cells on the ground, which anybody can run over and get healed. Which is really cool. You don't target your allies to heal them. It's kind of, you kind of put it down strategically, maybe you can put it on them, and it's up to them to get healed, sort of. I do have like this AoE heal, which is just goes in front of me, so I do have to kind of aim that one. But I really like not having targets, kind of. I mean, there is, you can target guys in this game, but none of your moves are targeted. They're all like dumbfires, kind of, which I think is really interesting. Hey, I got an item for a thing, apparently. I guess I have that recipe? I don't know. Oh god. Magic missiles incoming. I just need three more meats. You guys, give me more meats. None of you give me meats, that's so disgusting. There's something else that's gonna say interesting about my character, I don't know what it was. Anybody can dual wield, I think, as long as you have an offhand weapon. I have an offhanded weapon, but I couldn't tell that it was doing anything. I mean, I could swing with it separately. So maybe like if you have like a hammer in one hand for blunt damage and the knife in the offhand for piercing damage, it's good so you can maximize damage types, but I don't really know. So I completed the mission, I got the 6 foods, and I can hit backspace to teleport to mission giver, which is so nice. That's easily my favorite feature of this game. Don't go yet, I'm starving to death. The meat you brought me came too late. What must I do? Came too late. You're starving to death? I'll ask if there's anything you particularly want. Eat those young leaves. They're thin and wet. Yes, they will be good. Why can't you get leaves yourself? Are they attached to living things and you want me to tear them off? You monster. So the map, you can see I am in the right area for the mission. I don't really know what she wants me to do. Looks like something in the grass. This grass? Is that your time? Oh. Looking through the pile of grass. What the cuss did I just get? What was that? I don't know where it went. Not a mission thing. Oh, there it is. It's a quest thing. An item exchange between lovers is a symbol of their love. A cute music box that fits into a small pouch. What the heck am I supposed to do with that? I don't have a... You discard the music box back to where it was. I'm gonna take it again. I don't know what you want me to do with it though. That's actually really interesting. That's very, I kinda like the lack of explicitity on what I do with that. Although if I never figure out what to do with it, that would really suck. Are there going to be other leaf piles? Am I gonna stumble across an NPC looking for a leaf box? Was that part of my mission, or was it just an item I could interact with? Hey, you, oh, you, I see you. There. Collecting young leaves, excellent. Oh god dang it, I got interrupted. I hate this game so much with these interruptions. It's bullshit, it just adds time to everything. I hate it so much. And I also hate when enemies run, because enemies... Oh, I cut my hand, that sucks. Enemies will run sometimes, and they run way faster than you can possibly chase them. And so unless you're a ranged class, it basically means you have to slowly walk over there and kill them, or you have to wait for them to come back so you can kill them. And this is just a very tedious, boring thing, because like in a game like World of Warcraft, if an enemy runs away from you, one, you can chase them down because you can move fast enough, and two, you have to, because if they run to other enemies, they'll aggro more enemies, and that's a big deal. In this game, when enemies run away, it just means, you have to waste some more time. It takes you a little longer to kill me. It doesn't make it harder, doesn't have any risk or extra reward associated with it. It's just an obnoxious little thing to make what you're doing even more tedious and time consuming. And it's rude, I tell you. Can I interact with this thing? The abandoned altar. That's probably for a quest. Unless I could leave the box there, which I don't think I could. Ah, you. Don't make me bleed. No, don't interrupt me. Jerk. Okay, I got one. Cool. And I'm just ignoring these guys because they're really low level. Oh, god dang it. Maybe I can't afford to. Why do you chase so far? See, that guy's gonna run away. There's no point to chasing him. Did you see how fast he ran away? He practically teleported. It's so dumb. It is the worst mechanic in this game. And he's gonna come back, and I'm gonna kill him and aggro more guys. Great. Oh, god dang it, game. Oh, he's gonna run away too. Why weren't you dead? Okay, it's gonna kill everybody. Wipe them out. All of them. That's the Armstrong way. Take that. Okay, we got two leaves. We just need two. Oh, there's a chest over here. Chests are always hiding behind things. And they give you journals. So basically, you take the journals to somebody in either of the two capital cities. And the journal will have a bunch of stuff associated with it, like random drops from the creatures of that zone that the journal is associated with. And if you can supply those items, you get a buff to your character, which is a really, really cool system. But I don't think I've completed a single journal yet, because it just takes a staggeringly high number of things which never drop. So unless I go out and just farm, which is kind of by definition boring, I'm never going to complete any of the journals. But it's a cool system in practice. What did I get? The recipe for the flamini, which I'm also never going to craft because I'm not going to take the time to grind out the never dropping resources. Things just don't drop. Things are so hard to get in this game. Like there's my friend was grinding for a thing, so he looked online to see what it was. It dropped, has like a 1%, no. It has a less than 100% drop rate of an enemy that has a 1% spawn rate, and there can only be one in a zone at a time. And in this game, last hit's what matters. So if I'm killing a thing and somebody else walks by and gets the last hit, it cancels their kill, their loot, etc., etc. Which is another reason that this character was so hard to level, because everyone was last hitting all the time because my damage was so low. It's just the worst. And yet, so I'm complaining about this game a lot, and yet I still find it oddly attractive. I don't know what it is about this game that I actually like, but there is something that I definitely like about it. I think it just has that, it's very good at pacing out the reward thing, because there's always something to level up, there's always something to acquire, the quests are kind of cool, combat feels a little bit okay, even if it's a little bit boring, but it's not bad. I don't know. What do you want? You want food too? Everyone here wants food. Obtain Kapari flesh from the Kaparis. This is the same quest over again, pretty much. That's just boring quest design. You failed. What did I get? A thing for crafting. Oh, he did a thing on me. Something I didn't mention that's kind of important is... So I showed you... like this armor mastery type stuff. I didn't show you what's below it. So these are all just passive things which can be used to modify your moves. And you can train these at the trainer. Each class has a person, and this is the person who will sell them reagents for their moves, and it will also teach them these passive things for each of their moves. So for example, like one of the big ones for priests is so my heal spell, this thing that puts out squares, by default, if an enemy passes over these, it'll consume the square and deal damage to the enemy. And that's pretty cool for solo play most of the time. But for group play, when your main role is not damage dealer, it's healer, you really, really need to have that passive ability which turns it off so enemies don't affect the squares at all. I mean, most of the other moves are really straightforward, just like increased damage, increased effectiveness, increased duration or whatever. But some of them can change them pretty drastically, like add an armor debuff onto the move or whatever. So that's pretty important. and neat. It's not the most, like, it's not the richest system, because they just kind of walk up and you pay somebody money, and it takes between instant training the skill to half an hour. So it's not, again, a most engaging system, but it's not bad either. So I get it? No, I'm just bleeding. Oh no, I still got it. I'm out of here, suckers. Boom. You there, got your leaves. You like those leaves? You're still hungry. She's gonna attack me. She's gonna turn into a monster and attack me. Oh wow, she turned into a boss plant. Jeez, okay. Well, level 121, that's pretty high level. I'm gonna put on my armor skin. I'm gonna put on, which move is which? I think Y. Yes, it's my big old buff. Am I getting poisoned? I don't know. I got stone skin on, I'll be fine. And a punch, and a punch. I'm not punching you, am I? Are you invincible? Oh, good's hitting you. This is hit you all the things. Oh, big AoE. A lot of the moves you can jump over, the timing is really hard on them. But it's kind of cool. I just kind of wish it was a little more fleshed out. Because, like, right now, maybe it's my character because he's so tough. I kind of just sit here and wail on him a little bit. Let my stamina go back up, do some more double punches. I kind of just ignore the traps. But as you can see, they have a lot of HP, and they don't really deal a lot of damage. So I spend most of my time just holding down a button. I will have to heal in a second, though, because my invulnerability wore off. Which is too bad. And I'm going to jump over that thing. Yay, I think I did it. Those things come to hit me? They are. They hit me. Oh, jeez. Come on, stone skin again. Let's heal up a little bit. And resume fighting. I've never fought an immobile monster. That definitely makes it a little less engaging. Double punching! Double punching! It's not doing any extra damage at all. This thing's like immune to my... I put on a buff that normally drastically increases my damage by adding a holy component of damage to it. But this thing... Who knows? You can see that second number, 78, it's hitting for good stuff. But when I double punch, it's only doing one. I don't know why that is. And you're dead. And you're dead! There we go. Two level 6 experience cards and one carnivore necklace. Is that a good necklace? Probably not. Carnivore necklace. 68 SP, which is kind of like your mana recovery rate. And 9 poison property resistance. Yeah, that's terrible. Magic defense is also only 9. Oh, you're still alive. My necklace, my music box. I have them both for you. Keep listening to him. It's a hymn. Good God.
Julius, I'm sorry.
Lilia passed away. Make a grave for her. Oh, that's a... Oh, God. That's a really dark mission. Wow. What was the thing she was looking for until the end? I'm sure it has a sad story behind it. So I need to find Julius. Didn't explain to me why she was a carnivorous plant monster. I'm kind of curious about the why. Oh, he's still glitching out down there. Very odd. But I guess the moral of the story is, if one of your friends turns into a terrible monster, just beat the crap out of them and it'll make them better. Because she got better right before she died, right? She was cured or something. You're Julius. Hello. Meat quickly. I feel like I'm dying. Ah, yes. I need to get you more meat. But you have the same symptoms. I'm going to beat the crap out of him too, aren't I? I feel like maybe I should have talked to him after having talked to the other pilgrim. I don't know. You guys dropping meat at all? You guys aren't dropping meat. This is just a fool's errand. Like, even the mission items have a low drop rate, let alone the extracurricular, like, crafting journal items. And enemies, I think enemies have a pretty good spawn rate. I don't know. It's very hard to balance a game, especially early on in its release, because sometimes if you make the spawn rate too low, then there's too many players, so people can't really play the game because they're waiting for spawns. But if you make it too high, then later on in the game, it makes it really, really hard. Let me heal up before I talk to you and you turn into a monster. Okay. Meat, please give it to me fast. Gave it to you, buddy. Wait, that music box, what is it? My memories, she gave it to me, that's mine. gave him the music box. For 3 cards, that's cool. Oh, but set him off. It turned into a Drapelion. This is a Korean game, by the way, that explains the weird monsters at all. Restrained attack. Oh, I've been silenced. Silence also means no attacking. I don't know why. It's weird. There, it went away. Cool. Okay, I'm just gonna punch you a bunch again. That's my modus operandi. Hexing me, don't hex me, bro. I don't know what that did exactly. He looks cool. His attacks look cool. I actually have to move a little bit, I guess. Oh, my holy damage is doing plus 100 damage for holy. That's... Sometimes it's really nice to be a monk. Or a priest. Unfortunately... So the way the buff works is on my attacks, it deals extra damage. And you can see the second number flying per hit. I'm very sad that second doesn't proc on a double punch. That's really lame. Super lame, I would say. I can hit space? What did I hit space? Trying to persuade him. Yeah, let's do it. Cool! I wonder if I could have killed him or if it would have frozen and stopped. 3 more cards. Hot diggity.
Oh no, what was I doing? Oh my Lilia. We left for a pilgrimage to the great cathedral to receive the blessings of the goddess to celebrate our wedding.
But then that evil Nactus, that unforgivable demon lord, her music box and necklace were snatched by Nactus's servants and infused with Nactus's curse. It is as if they're trying to mock Maven's teachings. I have no idea what the story is in this game. I've not been doing a good job at all of reading the lore or anything.
Wait, my head still rings due to the curse.
I have many short stories to tell you. I don't know if I'll be able to endure until then. Tell me. I heard the Acillus at the Hollow Tree Forest have purifying powers. I should be able to endure with its purification.
Okay, I'll go get you your pure whatever.
Pure bowl is what it is. This game's dead though. Normally there's a lot more chattiness going on. I feel like... Because I played for a bunch, I was kind of in the forefront of the players, more roughly-ish. I feel like having taken a break, I'm now in the butt end of the players. So everyone's just progressed past me. Because I paid money to play this ahead of time. It's not out, it's not free to play yet. But I kind of wanted to beat the crowd. Which I think was a good decision. Because it was very credited initially. Oh, there are 2 unstacked. Excellent. Give me more, give me more. You guys won't aggro, right? You'll just leave little old me alone? Of course not. It's 2 of you, turds. Just die. Don't heal. And you run away. Whatever. It's the stupidest mechanic. It's so poorly used and implemented. Oh, just run. God dang it. Come on. There we go. I can harvest in peace. Oh, you dropped the recipe, though. That's kind of cool. And he didn't even run back. They don't even always run back. Which is terribly annoying. You hiding piece of crap. The game looks great though. I love the art in this game. That's definitely one of the things that sold me is just kind of how... I guess pretty is the adjective I'll go with here. Pretty I think the art is. Oh, they aggro. They hate it when I touch their leaves. God dang it. To murder you all. Or make you run away. That's... better, I suppose. Oh, I can turn and miss. But I missed. There we go. 2 dead. You cast a spell before dying. It did you no good. The fact that they don't run back all the time is just... It just enhances my bafflement for the whole system. Thank you very much. It's really gotten better. The music box, my Lilia, she may no longer be in this world. If you run into any of Nactus's possessions, please be sure to carefully inspect them for her sake. The symbol of our love that the demons swallowed. Please accept it as our gratitude for helping us claim revenge. How did you get it if you swallowed it? That symbol is a necklace blessed by the great cathedral, so it must be very useful. To me, that necklace no longer holds any meaning. Are you talking about that crappy necklace I just kind of dissed a few minutes ago? Yeah, the carnivore necklace. Oopsie. Still think it's crap, though. Erwhirl. That like to say, ah, Lilia, I'll never see you again. Indeed. Okay, that's sad. We have to look through the lump of rotten meat at Ascetic Sanctuary. That sounds like the most appealing way I could possibly choose to spend my time, looking through lumps of meat. I'm gonna go... I don't know. I should go down first. I'll continue going up, I guess. No, I'm gonna go down. Never mind, I'm going down. Because sometimes you can, you know, uncover side missions, and the bonus for 100% exploring a map is actually quite high. Well worth the time it takes, assuming things go smoothly. Sometimes areas don't get considered as being explored for a long time, which is really, really stupid, because it's really, really hard to see the faint bit of shadow in a corner or whatever. But I'm sure I've missed a lot of content, actually, because I run around looking at this map, making sure I can see when it gets lit up and explored. I'd be very surprised if I haven't missed content by looking too much at the map and not seeing my surroundings. Like, I just ran by an NPC, because an NPC won't show up on the map until you've talked to them, which is mildly irritating as well. Also, you need to keep your eye out for new chests and that sort of thing, if I hadn't already uncovered the chest, of course. Like this. Can I talk to this grave? I cannot talk to that grave. Some graves you can talk to. Well, I mean, talk to the ghosts in them, or whatever. This. Just scenery. Sometimes, they got really, I don't know, carried away with the level design, because they'll be like, beautifully drawn, like, scenery thing. Like, if you follow in the path, there'll be a beautifully drawn set of stairs, I can walk up them, I'll go down a hallway, there'll be another beautifully drawn set of stairs, and that stair set is behind an invisible wall, for some reasons. Like, if you're gonna put an invisible wall there, why'd you bother drawing the stairs? Doesn't make any sense. Are you attacking me? No. Okay, let's look at this meat. Searching through the rotten meat. I did notice there's other rotten meat back there. Oh, what are you? You're pretty cool. You got a tree on your head. I like you. You're pretty cool. I'd like to party with that guy. Let's put some buffs on. Boom. We're buffed. We're so buff. Just beat the crap out of some monsters now. Hi-ya! Hi-ya, I say. Hi-ya. Good thing I got some sweet AoEs. Oh, I did not dodge that at all. I blocked it though. I got lucky. Is it my stone skin? What it does is it increases my block chance. So I don't take less damage per hit. It's just the hits don't land as often. That's a really high damaging move. But we're full health again. This guy is still low level. I'm definitely having an experience penalty for fighting low level guys. So I probably would have gotten more experience. More visible experience if I hadn't delayed. Oh, what is hitting me? My shield broke, that's too bad. Or not my equipment shield, I mean. I have a move, it's like a safety zone. Magic missile. Okay, more healing. The healing works weird in this game, because my move basically has two charges before it starts cooling down. But normally what I'd want that to do is basically I'd want it to be every cooldown time I get a charge of healing. But that's not how it works. Basically I have to use both charges before the cooldown starts. Or if I wait one full cooldown, it'll reset as well. So what I just did just now is actually really, really bad tactically. Oh, he's bugged out. I can't even see him. Bugged out. Where I used my second charge before the cooldown. So basically I had to wait two full cooldowns in between. It's a weird system. Fortunately, I'm not having to heal super frequently. He's pretty dead. Let's put up a safety zone. The safety zone's nice because it just means I can focus on healing. I don't get distracted by anything. Hit him with some dots. Oh, I haven't been doing this move. I have a move which reduces his armor, which is pretty slick. Oh, I got knocked down. Put up my armor. Boom. I'm not using all my buffs either. I'm very stingy with the buffs. I should probably be using my buffs, more of my buffs, but they each take a reagent, so I don't use them as aggressively as I possibly could. The Necklace of Gluttony! That sounds metal. Okay, let's see what the Necklace of Gluttony does. Necklace of Gluttony. I hope you're actually good. Oh wow, 5 stars. I've never seen anything that high before. Why is it actually so terrible? Made by Maven, who wished to help his disciples as clerics. It helps you reach a higher level of faith after trials and ordeals. It has one magic defense, which is down from 20, and it gives me plus 10 strength, which is good. I don't get why it's so special, though. It helps you reach a higher level of faith after trials and ordeals. Is there something about this necklace? Is there some hidden quality to it where it will level up as I level up, for example? I don't know. But I think this is, well, it actually went way longer than I thought it would. This is giving you a pretty good look at Tree of Saviors. If you want to see me play more, maybe just stream more, we can hang out, because, you know, talking during this kind of thing is, it's very conversational, I guess. There's not a lot to me to react to, a lot for me to react to. So if you want to see more, let me know in the comments below. Let me know in what way you'd like to see more. If you want to see less, let me know and I'll take this down immediately. Not really, probably. But I hope I gave you a pretty good picture of what this game is. It will hit free to play. I don't know. Look in the description below. I will do the research and I'll put it in the description when this game is supposed to hit free to play on Steam. Thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Signature catchphrase.